Hey everybody, it's 2021 and we wanted to do a quick video to highlight our burn trailer, something we're super proud of. We started it last winter. We bought a bare bones trailer and we have outfitted it to meet our needs and more. So we're just going to do a quick video. And there's my beautiful daughter Savannah and her new puppy Luna. They're going to help us. But in any case, we'll give a quick rundown. We came in here, this thing was bare bones. We outfitted it to, you know, hold everything that we might need, or at least the vast majority of everything we might need for prescribed burning. We've put up as much information, you know, about burning in the trailer as we can. Some facts that, you know, we might need quick reference guides, if you will. Burning categories, this is old. So we've got the new one up here to replace that with, the new smoke management burning category for North Carolina. I think it came out in May of last year. Couple champion cabinets that we use to store anything and everything that we might need. We've got my medic first aid kits at both doors. We've got fire extinguishers at both doors. Anywhere where we thought we might house liquids, whether it's drip torch fuel, diesel, gas, we actually used chrome plates and stainless steel barriers. We have our council rakes, some new Rogue rakes and hose that we got this year that we're excited to use, some Coaxure FS1 packs for anybody on burn crew that might not be on a UTV or an ATV. This will give them all of the storage capabilities that they need to be as safe as possible when we're out doing a burn, whether that burn is 2 acres or, you know, 200 acres, which hopefully we'll get some of those bigger burns or at least amass more acreage every year. That's our goal. We have our DeWalt job lights that we use for, you know, bringing visibility to our work area around the trailer. Helps us to keep track of all of our gear to make sure that we secure everything properly, and so that we don't lose anything or you know, damage anything in transit. We have one of our cordless leaf blowers, you know, for longer, heavier duty jobs where we might need a leaf blower on a fire break. We'll use our Husqvarna, our gas powered. We have our helmets, our information booklets that we keep in the burn trailer you know, like I said, as reference, or if we are fortunate enough to share information with folks, we pretty much have every publication that we have found helpful somewhere in the trailer. Our chainsaw equipment, as far as our PPE for chainsaws, our cork board that has our burn maps, burn plan, burn permit, which is uber important. Our drip torch station for at least 4 of our torches. You know, we have more torches if we need them, but we always carry 4 in the trailer when we can. This beautiful bare spot up here is actually where my dry erase board goes, that we would write weather conditions, various other things down. But my beautiful wife, she borrowed it for Pictionary, and we have yet to put it back up. Some more booklets that we have found helpful through the years, a couple of our hats just hanging around. Some more storage. We have gloves, torches, all sorts of things storage wise. We have our eyewash station, that's always important. I mean, you can get stuff in your eye anytime, and these can be invaluable. Another, of course, my medic, our pit posse station. We can store food, we can store other medical supplies in here if we need to, paper towels, of course. We have other forestry equipment in here too, like our calipers. When we're going to inventory your crews, a bigger job, calipers are definitely the way to go when you're selectively marking, especially if you've got a couple people or a crew of people. Our radios, and we use for charging radios on the job, we use these Jackery or other portable power stations that we have invested in to keep, you know, juice to our radios in the event of a long day or night. For bigger stuff, we added this year, we added this Predator gas power generator that will give us extra capacity to run various pieces of equipment or charge things here and there, what have you. We have, you know, in our cabinets, we keep other components of prescribed fire that we need, or other gear, our masks, our goggles. Of course, we have some disposable gloves for stuff. Here is some extra lanyards for our cruise prisms for timber cruising. We have our little RX Fire goodies that we had the girls at Sandhill Sun. They made us some decals to kind of share our excitement. We have these little push pins that we had made this past year to give out to folks, kind of again share our excitement for prescribed burning and everything that it does for wildlife and for you know, improving our lands across North Carolina and across, you know, the country. And that's about it. I'll share some other stuff as we go along, but I know Thomas and a couple other people had asked to see, you know, kind of how we outfitted our burn trailer last year, and this is kind of a quick rundown of that. And you know, I tell people it'll take us 30 years of burning and all of the equipment that we have in here, but when you're passionate about something, you know, you go big or go home. We wanted to be as capable, as prepared as possible to have every piece of equipment at our disposal when, you know, when we're doing burns and when we're trying to help somebody. We just want to be as prepared as we can, and I think we are. I think this trailer sets us apart, not only visually, but from a preparation standpoint. You know, if we could burn thousands of acres a year, we certainly would, just because we know the benefits of prescribed burning for all things wild, especially deer, turkey, quail, and a lot of the other game species that we love. But with that, we'll end this, and you know, I'm sure we'll be back with more, you know, moving forward. But my model daughter, Savannah Bell, she's just helping us. And of course, the girls at Sandhill Signs, they use some of our images, some of deer pictures and turkey pictures that Chance and I took, and other images to do this wrap for us. They designed it, and we had a crew out of Fayetteville to put it on. But we're super proud of it, and we look forward to getting out there and sharing our excitement for prescribed burning with anybody and everybody that will listen, and burning as much acreage as we can from now until the day we die. But thank you guys. Have a good day.
An auction sale day after tomorrow at the end of Lincoln Line. 30 years of farming, 30 years of heartache, 30 years of day to day. Oh, my daddy stopped talking the day the farm was auctioned. There was nothing left to say.